Welcome to Wednesday night. This is the days of awe. These are the days in which we're doing exactly what God said to do in Joel 2. Call a solemn assembly, anoint, gather the congregation, sanctify them, gather the elders, let them pray between the porch and the altar. That's what's going on tonight. And so we're gathering you. We're blowing the trumpet. We're sanctifying ourselves because this is the holiest. In fact, they call this the High Holy Week on God's calendar. Rosh Hashanah has started. We are now in the birthday of the earth. The most incredible information that I have heard in my lifetime that I did not know that in 1948 before Christ, this is 1,948 years after Adam was born, that Abraham was born on Rosh Hashanah. And then 75 years later in 2023, before Christ, this was before Christ, that he was called out and God made a nation. Something's gonna happen because here we are now in 1948 AD, Israel became a nation, and now we are living in 2023. Ladies and gentlemen, brothers and sisters, everybody listening to me, something is about to happen. You don't make that up. This is an incredible week, High Holy Week, in which God is about to do something phenomenal to our world and to the believers. As far as we know, this Sunday will be, we know it's going to be Atonement, and we are bringing our Atonement offering. But is the rapture going to take place? Is this the time in which he's going to make the decision? I don't know, but I'll tell you what. I want to gather the people, sanctify them, and tonight we're going to take communion. Tonight we're anointing every person that comes into the house. We are unveiling the Ark of the Covenant, which is one of God's holy pieces of furniture. Now there is a real Ark of the Covenant in heaven. Tonight we are going to have praise and worship, and the Katinas are with us, and then we move right into baptism. The service is going to flow, but let me tell you, healing is going to be upon the people. So I am excited about Wednesday night, Atonement, sanctifying. This is a holy convocation, This is a God-called service because he calls it. He said, this week, during Rosh Hashanah, gather the people and anoint them. Many people do not know what this hour holds. And so they say it's no big deal. It's a big deal to God because the books are open. The accuser of the brethren comes this week. He uses your name trying to do his best to get God, not you, to put you in the book of the living and the book of the righteous. But instead, he is trying to manipulate. But let me tell you, God said, if you sanctify yourselves and you congregate together, especially in this week, the blessings will come and they will be double portion blessings. I'm excited. I'm excited about Sunday when we come and we stand before the Lord and we say, Lord, here's my atonement offering. Let's go into the service. Let's experience. Now you're going to notice I got a dark jacket, but I'm going to put a white coat on because tonight we have asked as many people to be in white because it is a sign of purity. So the whole congregation is going to have something to wear in white. I can't wait. As we lift up the name of the Lord, somebody may say, why do you dress in white? Because God required during the Atonement Week that everyone would wear tunic white that represents purity. So we're honoring that. We're going to have lots of fun. We're going to experience God's power, and it's going to be great. Let's go into the service right now, and let's experience Holy Convocation Atonement Wednesday night.
Praise the Lord.
Hey,
let everything that has breath,
we
Praise the Lord. Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
Yes, Lord.
Hallelujah. Woo.
Yeah.
Something new. We know that you're right here in the midst. Your presence is available. Your promise is attainable. Possibilities are limitless. The possibilities are limitless. Can I get an amen?
Amen.
Can I get an amen?
Amen.
Oh, when you say your promise, we'll say yes and amen.
Can I get an amen?
Amen.
Can I get an amen?
Amen.
Oh, when you say your promise, we'll say yes and amen.
Oh!
Heaven opens when we sing, your people claiming victory. The gates of hell, they tremble at the sound. The power of God is on our side. And in the name of Jesus Christ, every single stronghold will come down.
I know.
I know every single
stronghold will come down. Can I get an amen?
Amen.
Can I get an amen?
Amen.
Oh, when you say your promise, we'll say yes.
Can I get an amen?
Amen.
Can I get an amen?
Amen.
Oh, when you say your promise, we'll say yes and amen.
Let me say, can I get an amen?
Amen.
Can I get an amen?
Amen.
Amen. Oh, oh, oh.
Amen.
Come on now.
Standing on the word of God, we know the best is yet to come. Miracles bring all when we agree. Yeah. You give
no way through. We've heard the tide will never change. They haven't seen what you can do. Come on, sing it out. So much power.
So much power.
Oh yeah.
In your name.
Move the unmovable. Break the unbreakable.
God, we believe.
Yes, we do.
God, we believe for it.
From the impossible, we'll see a miracle.
God, we believe.
We believe for it. Oh yeah.
We know that hope is never lost.
No.
For there is still
an empty grave.
God, we believe no matter what. There is power in your name.
So
you said,
I believe,
you said.
Jesus. You said, I believe. You said, it is done. You said, I believe. Because you said it. We know it's done. Because you said it.
Sunday is the Day of Atonement. Joel 2 says, call a solemn assembly. Sanctify the people. Let the priests and the ministers weep between the altar. Spare the people. Tonight, every one of you were anointed when you came into the place. Now we're about to take Holy Communion because this is the days in which we repent. If the rapture of the church takes place, it is this season. This is the Feast of Trumpets. We are celebrating the birthday of the earth. Sunday will be the Day of Atonement, which is the birthday of man. This is a very, very holy feast. The Bible says these feasts are the Lord. They're not Jewish. They're not Christians. They're his feast. Feast means that God makes an appointment with man. I don't know about you, but I want God to make his appointment with me. What about you? One of the greatest things that we can do under the new covenant, take Holy Communion. If you don't have a cup, if you don't have a cup of communion, raise your hands. And would all of our people and elders and ushers be kind enough to look for those hands that are lifted, because I want you to have a cup of communion.
Thank you.
Everyone, take your cup of communion. Apostle Paul says in Corinthians, he said, many sleep, many are sick, and many are weak because they do not take Holy Communion. What Paul is saying is this: you cannot die before your time if you take Holy Communion. In examining yourself, you will be healed. You say, Pastor, I don't have any problems right now. Well, let me tell you, I would make sure the virtue is inside of me, that when sickness does come, it can't stay there very long. And then it will make us strong. We always look to the cross, because when we do this in remembrance of him. And so he says, let us examine. And since it's a holy convocation night, it's a night in which I compliment all of you that have wore white. God asked on the Day of Atonement that there would be the tunics would be white. So tonight, we represent purity. Purity, not by our own works, but by the works of Jesus Christ, who has made us a brand new creature. Old things are passed away, and behold, all things become new. Can I hear anybody say a great big amen to that?
Amen.
So what do? In this sanctify, you've been anointed. Now this moment of holiness with communion. The Bible says, let a man examine himself. And the best way to do that is to pray a prayer like this that I'm going to lead you in, of repentance. So everyone, pray this prayer with me as you look to the cross. As Jesus died for you, Jesus shed his blood for you. Say these words with me. Say, oh Lord.
Oh Lord. Oh Lord,
I thank you.
I thank you.
For dying for me.
For dying for me.
Forgive me.
Forgive me.
If there is anything in my life. If
there is anything in my life.
There's unforgiveness.
Unforgiveness.
There's doubt.
If there is doubt.
Whatever it might be.
Whatever it might be.
Give me a clean heart.
Give me a clean heart.
Let your blood.
Let your blood.
Cleanse me.
Cleanse me.
In the name of Jesus.
In the name of Jesus.
I take. The fruit of the vine.
The fruit of the vine.
That is in this cup.
It represents your blood.
The unleavened bread. That I take today.
Represents your body.
And in the name of Jesus.
In the name of Jesus.
I will receive.
I will receive.
Healing.
Healing.
Strength.
Strength.
And life.
And life.
I just want to say to everybody, bullets will have to pass you. Accidents will have to pass you. Evil will have to pass you. And we all are scheduled to die, but when you take Holy Communion, the devil cannot take you out before your time. So now, in the name of the Lord Jesus, on high holy weeks, the week of Rosh Hashanah, we now take Holy Communion.
Oh, hallelujah. Praise the one who set me free. Hallelujah. Grave that's lost its grip on me. You have broken every chain. There's salvation in your name. Jesus Christ, my living hope.
Place, give some hallelujahs. Give a hand clap of praise to the Almighty God. Let everything that hath breath praise ye the Lord. You may be seated for a moment and all stay in place. And the song you were singing before this song, just do that for a moment. Anyone here tonight who the doctor said that you have cancer, stand to your feet because you're going to be healed tonight. You got cancer. wave your hands, or let me see you. Turn the lights on the balcony. Let me see. Somebody say, in the name of Jesus.
In the name of Jesus.
We rebuke that cancer.
We rebuke that cancer.
Be healed now.
Be healed now.
In the name of Jesus.
In the name of Jesus.
Any person that is in here tonight that has any high blood pressure, whatever it might be, I won't be able to cover it all in telling what it is, but there is something that you want God to heal you of. I'm going to tell you to stand, and I'm going to claim that in the name of Jesus, and the rest of us are going to claim you're going to be healed in the name of Jesus. Who are you? Stand up right now, and everybody that's sitting, just begin to believe God right now, in the name of Jesus. In the name of, come on somebody, where's the believers? Be healed, not tomorrow, not next year, right now, in the name of Jesus. Somebody just say, in the name of Jesus.
In the name of Jesus.
The name above every other name.
The name above every other name.
Now I want you to just take your faith. Everybody standing. Come on. I want you to get out of the boat. And I want you to claim God has healed you.
Yeah.
By beginning to clap your hands and say, thank you, Lord, for my healing.
Thank you, Lord.
Come on, use your faith.
Thank you, Lord.
That's good. Use your faith.
Thank you, Lord.
Use your faith. Somebody and say, you're healed. Just say that to somebody. You're healed. Thank you, Lord. You may be seated. Keep playing that song. I would like for everybody just to help my family. We normally don't do this. We don't bring attention to our family. But we pray for you, believe God for you, fast for you. And I want you to know that the ministry of this church is doing that. Some of you may have seen a bed up there by the cross tonight. And you may have seen a desk up there. That's where I am day and night. I'm living at that cross during these 10 days. Seeking God, all seeking God, asking God, fasting, praying. How many knows that fasting and praying really does a work in people's lives? But Shay Lee, you know, my granddaughter, who's my, she's my assistant. Sunday night, she had an attack, and she's been having these. And Melody and I rushed her to the hospital Sunday night, and Monday morning, her gallbladder was taken out. And she's 22. She's watching all of us tonight, I'm sure. Love Shay Lee. And all of you that know Shay Lee, she's lovable. But her liver enzymes have gone up, and they have to do another emergency surgery on her liver. But I'm going to believe, if you'll help me, I just need a couple people. Thank you. That will believe that in the morning there's going to be a miracle. Hallelujah. We believe it to be done. Shay Lee gonna be healed. Oh, listen to this church. I love you, Jesus, for this church. Thank you for the healing power. Go to community hospital right now and heal Shay Lee in the name of Jesus. Wow. Wow, Shaylee, did you see that? Did you hear that? Wow. Look at all these people that love you, Shay. Wow. Wow. I believe the miracle's gonna happen. I really sense that. Thank you. That's where Melody is tonight, at Community Hospital, and that right there just did it. Boy, you got. Turn to somebody and say these words. I'm glad I'm in a church that believes in healing.
Thank you, Jesus.
You may be seated after that. I'm so glad. This is a very holy week, a very special week. There is a young man that's turned into a mature man in his wonderful family. They've been raised in our church. In fact, he lived a segment of time with us. Brother Mike Beauvais, come up here. I am so proud of him because St. John, Indiana, here's a Holy Ghost-filled boy right here, was elected as the town board president. We need more Holy Ghost people. You have a mic? We're so glad that you're a leader, and we are going to believe that Northwest Indiana is going to have great leadership like you, Mike.
Thank you, Dad, Pastor Steve. It's a privilege to be here tonight, and I am so grateful that I've had people, men like this, in my life. I feel like I'm in church tonight.
Yeah.
I know you feel what I feel. This thing wasn't done in a back room. This thing was done on the day of Pentecost. That's what we're feeling. And this man is a warrior. I thought back, Brother Steve, to when we used to play softball together, and I don't know if you know this, but Brother Steve is a competitor.
Yeah.
He is a strong competitor.
And I was better than you. You remember
yes,
that?
Yes, he was. He was the leader. He coached us. He was a guy that he made us watch Zig Ziglar films on winning. He taught us everything about being a winner, about never giving up, about keeping on, pressing on, doing the best you can, trusting in the Lord. This is my brother. This is what he imparted to me. And I'm so grateful tonight that God's mercy, I was fortunate to run for the town election in St. John. And like Pastor Steve says, we need godly Christian
Amen.
Men. Spirit-filled men that will stand up with integrity, honesty, and do the right thing for the people that they're going to serve. And I'm just so grateful that God has chosen me. I never prayed. I contacted Pastor Steve. Pastor, pray for me. And you know what? Just like you said earlier, prayer works. Never asked to win. We asked for his favor. And I thank you for this opportunity and this privilege of being here, Pastor Steve.
Everybody stretch your hands toward him. He's one of leaders, many leaders, represents all of the leadership. Everybody say, in the name of Jesus.
In the name of Jesus.
In these holy days.
In these holy days.
Anoint.
Anoint.
Touch.
Touch.
Every leader.
Every leader.
Our mayors.
Our mayors.
Town board presidents.
Our town board presidents.
Our governors.
Our governors.
Our congressmen.
Our congressmen.
Our senators.
Our senators.
Our president.
Our president.
Every leader.
Every leader.
In the name of Jesus.
In the name of Jesus.
Lord, I pray for that new mayor of Chicago. That violence is going to come down in the name of Jesus. We're going to believe God. Mike, so proud of you being a leader. And I'm so proud of him because he's a Holy Ghost boy. Man, good things are going to come, and I'm just so proud. And on Holy Week, I wanted to acknowledge the leadership, and I want to say thank you. Thank you. Give him another great big hand. Thank you. Thank you so much. Now we're going to baptize tonight, and I'm so excited. But before we do that, I want to tell you, because Sunday is Atonement. Everybody needs to know that this is a very special year. Listen closely. I'm not going to belabor this. I'm just going to remind you, to excite you. The Bible said the sons of Issachar had understanding of the times. These were anointed people to share with the people of what time it was. and what God wanted to do with Israel, I want to point out some things before we unveil the ark, because Sunday we come and we bring our atonement offering, and that is going to be such an anointed time because God teaches us about the double portion, and it's God's idea to give the atonement. But listen to this closely. Make yourself listen just for this paragraph. Something is going to happen so huge this year, whether it is a rapture, whether it's God prospering you, blessing you. And I want to preface what I'm going to say, that God, listen to this closely, God is not a NASCAR race driver. He is not in competition with the devil. He always says to the devil, you go first. Always. When you read in the scriptures, the Bible said the enemy comes in like a flood. Then God raises up a standard. Weeping endureth for the night, but then joy comes in the morning. And I want to tell all of you, you all that have been through hell the last 4 or 5 weeks, I want to tell you the devil has went first. But you better get ready. God's getting ready to rise up in you a standard. So let me say this in just moments. This is Sunday will be a day of atonement. It's also the day in which man was made. The day of atonement is when God shut Noah's ark's door. This is the end time. This is the season in which he will come. We don't know the hour day, but this is the season. That's the reason why he says, I'm giving you 10 days to repent. This is the Feast of Trumpets. It's the Tabernacles. It's really sad that the pulpits do not study, and they only want to make people's ears feel good. The Bible said, study to show yourself approved. When you are a pastor or a leader, you should study the Word of God so you can be a watchman. You can sound the alarm. Somebody help me. Sound the alarm, you know. So, it's not going to be long, but I want you to hear this, that God always does things in this season of around atonement. That's the reason why the fourth quarters and the first quarters are better than the second and third, because double portion starts in atonement season. That's the reason why we educate our children from September to May, because the Bible says he'll pour out his spirit on sons and daughters and they'll prophesy. Your children go to school. I want to be a fireman. I want to be a nurse. I want to be a governor. I want to be a businessman. That's what they're doing. They're going to school. They're seeing their future. And it is in this season. And double portion happens right now. But at the same time, this week, this is the week when you study the Word of God and you really get in depth with it. This is the week that Satan accuses the brethren. The books are open on atonement, which just simply means judgment. You just have to study this. It will excite you because it's all understanding the times. There is the book of the living, there is the book of the righteous, and there's the book of death. And when you begin to study this, you'll find out, and even David talks about, don't let my name be blotted out of the book. And I'm not talking about the Lamb's Book of Life and the Book of Revelation. I'm talking about the judgment in which God, when he looks now in this season, he puts you in one of those books when you begin to study. This is the week that he schedules all deaths for the next year. He puts them in the book of death, or the book of the living, book of the righteous. This is when Satan comes and he is the accuser of the brethren. And he tries to get God to get your name in the book of wicked. But I want to tell you about Jesus' blood. When you say, God, forgive me, he remembers no more. I didn't hear anybody really get excited about that, but he remembers no more. So that's the reason why you're going through the battle. That's the reason why the earthquakes, the Libya. That's the reason why the fires in Maui. All of that happens. We had 9/11 at this season. All wars are started at this time. You study it. It's all in place because Satan is afraid that God's going to make a decision. And it could be that next week, that's when he will come, because that's the Feast of Sukkot, and we're all to get outside. And the Bible says, unto them that look for him shall appear. Now, for all of you that are so tied up in life and you love your stuff, God bless you, you're left behind. But for us that are looking for him, anybody looking for him, he will appear. So this is actually the season and time in which we prepare ourselves if he is to come. I don't know, but I'm going to tell you some shocking things right now. Benjamin Netanyahu, the prime minister today on national television, spoke these words. You never heard a prime minister out of the Jewish nation say these words. I'm ready to have peace with Palestine. I'm ready to have peace with the Arab world. You never heard that before. And that happened this week. Now I'm going to tell you something else. Did you know that Abraham was born in 1948 B.C.? Abraham. He was born in 1948 B.C., before Christ, 1948 years after Adam. When he was 75 years old, God called him out of Babylon, or the Chaldeans, which is a type of the rapture. He was 75 years old. Do you know what year that was before Christ? 2023. Now let me really blow your mind. In 1948, after Jesus died, 1948, Israel became a state and a nation. It is now 75 years later, 2023. God is the same yesterday, today, and forever. You better get ready. I don't know what God's getting ready to do, but I can tell you this. That when Abraham came out of Babylon, God made him rich. God made him influential. And when somebody tried to mess with his family, he put disease on them. You remember when he went down to Pharaoh, down to Egypt, and he told his wife, Sarah, he said, you're such a good-looking woman, you better tell the Egyptians that you're my sister, which is true because they both had the same father, but not the same mother, because Sarah was his half-sister. So he wasn't lying. Because he said, if they find out that I'm your husband, they'll kill me because he'll want you as his wife. Sure enough, they went to Egypt, and the Bible says that Sarah had to go to the Pharaoh's house. But the Bible says disease and sickness and death broke out in all of Pharaoh's place. That's a signal that when God brings you out, anybody that messes with you, no weapon formed against you shall prosper. God's getting ready to turn your situation around. And I don't know what he's up to, but I'm ready for something huge. And this is my last point. Here's my last point. God always says, devil, you go first. So you got all the songs. You got Hollywood. You got all the stuff. You got all the same-sex marriage. You got all the stuff, the abortion. You got all. God said, you go first. Because sin has a season. You mark it down before we leave this planet. God is going to raise all of you people in the body of Christ up. And I'm going to tell you that what's under the lights tonight that's popular will not be popular long. Because God's getting ready to have a mighty move of the Holy Spirit. And your sons and your daughters, and God is about to. Anybody excited about God doing something new? So what's going to happen before we have baptism? We are all going to go into the throne room of God. In a minute, you're going to go into the throne room, come boldly. And you're going to feel and sense the presence of God. And team, you did great tonight. But this. When we unveil the Ark of the Covenant, which is probably the most incredible piece, and this piece here was built by a carpenter and took a year to build, and it actually has the four heads of the cherubims on it. It's one of the only arcs I know. When it comes unveiled, remember there's an ark just like it in heaven, and Jesus is sitting between those cherubims. And Revelation say they're singing, holy, holy, holy. When that goes up tonight, we're going to mark it. It is Atonement Week. We're going to come boldly in the throne of God. Folks, you better get ready. God is getting ready to do something so spectacular in 2023. And in the next few moments, you're going to be ushered into the presence of God. Watch the unveiling of the Ark of the Covenant.
Well, this is one of my favorite groups in the body of Christ. And they haven't been here for a long time. And I don't even have the answer for that, why they have not been here for such a long time. They used to be our New Year's Eve special every year. And I mean, they just brought it on and brought it down with their worship. In the next few minutes before we have our baptism service, they're going to take us into the throne room. Let me tell you, their harmony, their spirits, their ministry for many, 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 many years, traveling, they're in the largest and the most successful churches in America weekly. And they are phenomenal. I can't believe they haven't been here in a while, but you're about to be ushered into the presence of God. And remember, when they start singing, when things start you feeling the presence of God, this is when miracles happen. Right before our baptism, one of the greatest groups in America, and they're brothers, and they have traveled, and they have done all over the world great things for God. Everybody come on, help me, because you're going to love them. You that don't know, never heard them. Let me tell you, you are about to get a big treat. Come on, everybody, let's get excited. Jump TV, everybody, come on, balcony, everybody, everybody. And welcome the Katinas from Nashville, Tennessee.
Hallelujah. Pray. I love. You bring light to the darkness. You give hope. You restore every heart that is broken.
Everybody sing with me.
Great are you, Lord. So we pour out our praise, pour out our praise. It's your breath in our lungs. So we pour out our praise to you only. It's your breath. It's your breath in our lungs. So we pour out our praise, pour out our praise. It's your breath in our lungs. So we pour.
Everybody standing to your feet, everybody standing with hands lifted up. The child is greatness right here, say.
All the earth will shout your praise. Our hearts will cry, these bones will say. Great are you, Lord.
Hey.
All the earth will shout your praise. Our hearts will clap, these bones will say,
great
are you, Lord.
Even though
it's your breath in our lungs, so we pour out our praise, we pour out our praise. It's your breath in our lungs, so we pour out.
Hallelujah. How you feeling, family? Everybody say peace.
Peace.
Come on, shout it out. Say peace.
Peace.
Somebody say love.
Love.
Somebody shout hallelujah. Come on and put your hands together like this. Come on. Hey.
If not for your mercy, if not for your grace, much better than okay. Peace, love, hallelujah. Throw my hands up to you and sing all the day long.
Give it up.
Peace, love, hallelujah. Lord, I give it to you. Sing it, this is my song.
Throw it up again. Come on, FCC. Everybody moving from side to side with me. Hey, come on. Sing the verse.
If not for your mercy, if not for your grace, don't know where I'd be, low on happy days. Thank you for your mercy, thank you for your grace. I smile cause I feel much better than okay.
Everybody say,
peace, love, hallelujah. Throw my hands up to you. Love, hallelujah, but I give it to you.
all back to you.
Never gonna stop.
Never ever gonna stop.
Come on.
I'm gonna give it all back to you. Oh, 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 oh. Oh yeah. Gonna give it all back to you. Never ever gonna stop. I'm gonna give it all back to you.
Come on, Indiana. Everybody say,
peace, love.
Weapon is a melody.
you're gonna hear my praises. Yeah, yeah, yeah.
We're going to have church tonight. Do me a favor before you're seated. Why don't you give somebody a high five and tell them, man, I'm going to sing a hallelujah all night long. As you're seated,
I'm going to sing in the middle of the storm.
Come on.
Louder and louder.
Yeah.
Gonna hear my praises roar.
Praises roar
up from the air.
Hope will arise.
Hope will arise. Death is defeated. The King is alive.
Everybody sing.
I reign.
Searched the world, but it couldn't fill me. Man's empty praise and treasures that fade, I never enough.
Oh Lord.
But then you came along and put me back together. Every desire is now satisfied here in your love.
Yeah.
Oh,
there's
nothing
better than you.
Show you my weakness, my failures and flaws. Lord, you've seen them all, and you still call me friend.
Friend, 'cause the God of the mountain,
oh, yeah,
is the God of the valley. There's not a place your mercy and grace won't find me again.
If I have some witnesses here in Indiana, you say,
oh, there's nothing,
no,
better than you. Nothing better than you.
Anybody believe the name? Nothing, no one better than Jesus.
Lord, there's nothing.
In the whole world better than you. Like the young people say, facts. Nothing better than Jesus. Thank you to one of our heroes. And we don't let him know enough, but even though we don't see each other and we may not talk all the time, but Pastor Steve, you are one of our heroes. You are a legend. And so honored, so grateful to be with you and Miss Melody and the whole family. As a matter of fact, if you've never seen us before, then you're new. We go way back, but it's so good to be with the family here. We are the Katinas. We are five real brothers, same mom, same dad. We are... Originally, we're from the Samoan Islands, a group of islands in the South Pacific. It looks nothing like Munster, Indiana. But aren't you thankful that because of the blood of Jesus and what he did on the cross, we're all family. We're related. We want to do a song for you that we've been writing music and sharing our music for the last 30-plus years. And... you know, during the shutdown back in 2020, we were freaking out just like everyone else. And we were in our studio trying to write, trying to be inspired. It was a little difficult in the moment. But it was as if the Holy Spirit dropped one word in that writing session, and the word was here. H-E-R-E, here. He wanted to remind us that no matter what the circumstances, no matter how crazy things were, he was here. He's wherever you've been in the last 3-4 years as we've been trying to navigate through all of the craziness, he's been here. Yea, though I walk through the valley of the shadow of death, I will not fear evil, because you are with me. No doubt God is here tonight.
Speak some.
word and calms the sea. Even so, I know
you'll meet me here. In the night, wide awake, I will speak a word of faith. I know you've got me, I know I can trust you. And if my mind is gonna race, then let it run away with praise for all that you've done and all I know you'll do. Oh.
Yeah. I'm a million miles away from all that's false. Doesn't matter if I'm struggling in the storm. So I know you'll meet me here. There's no place my broken heart would rather be.
With the one,
and with the one speaks the word and calms the sea. Even so, I know.
Wow, the presence of God is here. Thank you, Jesus. It's been some time since we've been here, so I want you to meet my brothers on bass guitar. This is James. Back on the drums back there, that's our brother Joe. Singing leads up front right here, this is James's twin. This is John. My name is Jesse. We got James, Joe, John, and Jesse. Give it up for our brother, Sam. As John mentioned, we are originally from the South Pacific Islands. We're 5 of 12 kids all together. Mom and Dad took that scripture to multiply the earth, literally. Our mother went to heaven many, many years ago. Our father is a Pentecostal preacher and a former Marine. That's not a good combination when you're a kid. But we want you to know that it's been a while, so we have some of our new music back in the lobby area. This is the latest one. It's titled Sunday Set, and it has a lot of, Sunday Set 2 has a lot of familiar worship songs that you probably sing right here throughout the week. And we have a few shirts. John, can you hold this one up? This is really the message that our mom taught us about growing up, to love God and love people. This is another one, a clear message that we need Jesus. We can do all things through Christ who strengthens us. And I know some of you, we are new to you, and you look up on stage and like, wow, they're all brothers. So they must have just grown up into this band that is now called the Katinas. I wish it was that simple, but in the early 80s, the original Katinas only consisted of a few brothers, Sam and Joe, and our other brother, Dave, who is a minister. And in the early 80s, they came back from tour back in the islands of Samoa, and our dad got the rest of us together and said, guys, I think it's time for John and James and Jesse to join the band. Dad, that sounds like a good idea. When do we start? He said, oh, not so fast. What we're going to do is we need you to write a speech. Craft your speech really well. Put some scripture in there. And when you present your speech, if it's good enough, we'll vote you in the band. Okay. I was 8 years old. So we gathered in the living room. John and James presented their speech. I don't remember taking a vote, but somehow they were automatically in the band. And I stood up and I read my speech. And Dad said, all right, guys, you heard from Jesse. If you think his speech was good enough, just raise your hand and we will vote him in. I looked to the left and I looked to the right. Not a single hand was raised. But our dear mom, she was in the kitchen and she overheard our conversation. She said, guys, I don't care what you all say, Jesse is in the band. Thank you, Mama. And you know, as funny as that story is, some of you are sitting here and can kind of relate. At times you feel unseen. At times you feel like no one notices you. At times you feel like your speech is not good enough. We're here on a Wednesday night to remind you that there is someone who votes for you every single time. You are fearfully and wonderfully made. He created you with a purpose. Jeremiah 29:11, the Lord declares of those plans to give you a hope and a future. When all hope is lost, we can find courage in knowing that all we need, the only vote that we need, is found in Jesus.
Oh, you inside of me. Now I'm alive and I'm breathing. You are the one that I need. Oh, I need Jesus. Shining like the morning light. Give me more Jesus. He can bring me back to life. Gotta have Jesus. Savior. Always right on time. Oh, I need Jesus. Gotta have Jesus.
In the middle of the night,
all I need is Jesus.
Sometimes when I'm about to lose my mind,
all I need is Jesus.
Oh, and I don't know why, I don't know why.
All I need is Jesus.
FCC, all I know is that I need Jesus in my life.
All I need is Jesus.
Come on, if you need Jesus, just sing right here.
Oh, I need Jesus.
Yeah. Come on.
Shining like the morning light. Give me more Jesus.
Those hands of the Father right now, everybody. Every hour, we need you, Jesus. Think about his goodness right now. Think about his faithfulness. Think about the miracles. Think about it right now. Come on, let's sing.
All my words fall short. I've got nothing new. How could I express all my gratitude? I could sing these songs as I often do, but every song must end, and you never do.
Come on, you say.
So I throw up my hands.
Thank you, Jesus.
Praise you again and again. 'Cause all that I have is a hallelujah. Hallelujah. And I know it's not much, but I'm nothing else fit for a king, except for a heart singing hallelujah. Hallelujah.
Here we go.
I've got one. I've got just one move. With my arms stretched wide, I will worship you.
Come on, family.
So I throw up my hands and praise you again and again. 'Cause all that I have is a hallelujah. For a king,
except for a heart singing hallelujah.
If you're feeling discouraged tonight, why don't you encourage your soul right here? Let's sing it out.
So come on, my soul.
Come on.
Oh, don't you get shy on me. Lift up your song. Cause you got a lion inside of your lungs. Get up and praise the Lord. So come on, my soul. Oh, don't you get shy on me. Lift up your song.
Come on, my soul. Oh, don't you get shy on me. Oh, come on, so sing it out.
You.
Yeah. If you're feeling discouraged, come on.
So come on, my soul.
Speak to me.
Don't you get shy on me.
Yeah, yeah.
Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Woo. Woo. You can be seated. Hallelujah, the highest praise. Oh, so much to be grateful for. So much gratitude tonight. Man, we were in Utah this last weekend, Saturday, Sunday, and Monday. And Friday we'll go out to LA. It's been a while since we've sung on a Wednesday night. And it's been a long time since we have had the pleasure of just being in God's presence like we are tonight on a Wednesday night. We didn't come here for you. God sent us here for us because we feel refreshed tonight. Pastor, thank you. Thank you so much. As John said, you are a hero and you are a voice for this nation, for our culture, for the time. Every time I see you on TV, I say, I know that guy. And a few months ago, we couldn't attend a funeral service, a memorial service for Bishop Phillips. So I watched it online, and you were the keynote speaker. And I was in my dining room, and my wife was like, "Why are you crying? Did you know Bishop that well?" And I kind of knew him okay, but I was crying listening to you preach the word. I was so inspired. I texted my brothers. I said, "Y'all got to listen to Pastor Steve. He's on fire right now." And after that night, I was like, "Man, we've kind of lost contact." So we saw a pastor maybe just earlier this month. And I said, "Pastor, we'd love to come back. I can send you some Sundays we're available." He said, "Oh, no, you got to come to Munster on a Wednesday." Yeah. And now I see why. So grateful. So much gratitude. Y'all look beautiful, by the way. This is what heaven is going to look like. Young. Older, black, white, brown, in one place, worshiping one God, with one love, with the truth that Jesus is still the answer for the world today. And he's coming back. He's coming back. We got to get out of the way because we can't wait for baptism. We cannot wait for baptism. But perhaps you're here tonight, and even as we sing gratitude and all these worship songs and people seem filled with joy, perhaps it's hard for you, if you're being honest with yourself, to feel grateful. Yes, sir. Things are not going well at your home. Yes, sir. You're struggling in your marriage. Maybe you've been through an ugly divorce and you feel shame. Your kids are not turning out the way you had hoped. Your finances are not where you wish they were. Perhaps in your home there's addiction. There's a struggle with alcohol or drugs or sex addiction or just abuse of all kinds. Can I tell you, brother? Can I tell you, sister? You're in the right place. You're with family. You're amongst family. As we've traveled this nation, me and my brothers, and I'm so thankful, we're so humble for the opportunity every time we get to do it. But after every service or every concert, there will be a mother that comes up to us and she'll say, "I wish my family was like your family." Mother, I got to tell you two things. There's good news and there's bad news. The good news is your family is just like our family. The bad news is your family is just like our family. You're looking in the mirror. Because when you look on stage, what we represent is an alcoholic father. We had a dad who was abusive, beat our mom. People thought there was no hope for Moses Katina. And some of those addictions passed on to us, struggling, trying to find our way, some child trauma that we came up with. And even though we grew up in church, never really dealt with the trauma, and it caught up. As they say in recovery, it works until it doesn't work. When you look on the stage, you're looking at brothers who lost their mom. We were just teenagers, and we prayed. We said, "God, would you please heal our mom?" And what do you do when the answer you get is not the answer you were looking for? Now, I've got to be honest, for a long time, I thought I had to defend God and like, "Oh, well, I'm 53 now, and I'm just starting to learn some things." God is sovereign. God is sovereign.
and life is tough. That's why he said in Philippians, be anxious for nothing, but by prayer and supplication, with thanksgiving, present your request to God. Why would he say don't be anxious? Because there's plenty of reasons to be anxious. We can come to church and we can be real. We can tell the truth. God said, come with thanksgiving, prayer, and supplication. Let me know what you need. And if you don't give up, the peace that surpasses all understanding will guard your heart and your mind in Christ Jesus. So for the brother, the sister, the mother, the father, the teenager, you feel alone right now. You feel unseen. You want to give up because life is crazy, right? It's cray cray right now for you. He who began a good work, he will be faithful to complete it. Because our God is great.
Savior God to thee, how great thou art, how great thou art.
Then sings my soul, my Savior God to thee,
how great thou art, how great.
How great thou art.
of acclamation and take me home. What joy shall fill my heart?
Come on, fam.
Yeah.
Then I shall.
See, we're going to take the offering. We're going to baptize right now, but we're going to take the offering, turn the law, the lights on. Let me see who's here tonight. Let me see who missed. See, let me check you out. You finally made it on a Wednesday night, right there. Thank God you'll get to go to heaven. You made it on a Wednesday night. How many's enjoyed the service so far? Isn't it been great? You can do it by envelope. You can do it by your phones as you give on the Wednesday night, the week, Holy Week. And guys, you have to do another song. So get a mic. You can do that. Can't they, Joe? Can they? The brothers just one song? Yeah, just a half a song. Just do a half a song. So as we give, the ushers are in the aisle. How many love to give to God? How many love to give to God? We're going to bring our atonement offering Sunday. This is a very holy night. We have sanctified, anointed. This is a very special week. This is a very holy week. And God is doing great things. Go on and start giving on your phones. That's it. Please leave them alone. 1,000, T-H-O-U-S-A-N-D. Leave them alone. Quit talking to them. Let them give. That's it. Everybody, we're giving to the Lord. You're so sweet, so kind. This is so wonderful to have us all, in most of us, dressed in white and purity, the sign of atonement. Love all of you all, and you're so special. I want you to know that I am praying for you as I'm at the cross night after night seeking God. But I want to tell you, great things are about to happen. I mean, that we have never, ever experienced in the history of your life. Are you giving? Everybody says, I'm giving. The container might come beside you or in front of you, and as it passes your way, just a half a song, just a half a song. These are my favorite guys, I'm telling you. They just tell me.
The sun comes up, it's a new day dawning. It's time to sing your song again. Whatever may pass and whatever lies before me, Let me be singing when the evening comes.
Choir sing.
Bless the Lord, oh my soul.
Yeah.
Oh my soul. Worship His holy name. Sing like never before. Oh my soul. I worship Your holy name. You're in. Your name is great and Your heart is kind. For all Your goodness I will keep on singing.
Yeah.
10,000 reasons for my heart to find. Bless the Lord for my soul. Oh,
forevermore.
10,000 years and then forevermore.
Bless the Lord, oh my soul.
One more time.
Bless the Lord, oh my soul. Oh my soul. Worship His holy name. Sing like never before. Oh,
balcony gift. Everybody give. I'm going to give by phones. Turn the lights out. Let me see all the giver by phones. Turn the lights out. Let me see all the. Wave them. Wave them. Wave them. Look at all the givers. Look at that. Boy, that's maturity. God bless you. I did that because somebody saw you and the offering basket was going by and they said they didn't give anything, so I made you raise your phone. That's what I can say. Everybody stretch your hand and say, thank you, Lord.
Lord.
That we are able to give.
That we are able to give.
This is the double portion season.
This is the double portion season.
And we're going to receive it.
And we're going to receive it.
In this week of atonement.
In this week of atonement.
In Jesus' name.
In Jesus' name.
You guys go right out that way. Now, guys, you got a half a song with our group? Just a half a song? No, a quarter of a song. Just a quarter song. Listen to this closely. Now, this is very special to us. And you guys wonder about Wednesday night. When they quit coming on Wednesday night is when I stop pastoring. Because we are not a weak church. We're not just a 90-minute church. Look at all of y'all. You're great, strong, strong church. So listen closely to this. We have all the baptismal clothing. We have the dressing rooms. I have everything ready to go for you. The waters are warm. We'll be baptized and where Jesus gets baptized. We're going to worship. You're welcome to stay, but let me tell you how important this is. You must be baptized. Jesus says, he that believeth and is baptized, water baptized, not sprinkled, water baptized. And the Bible says, he that believeth and is baptized shall be saved. If you do not get water baptized, he tells you, about salvation. It's very important. This is not a church idea. This is not the Pope's idea. This is not our church. This is not about membership. This is about salvation. And water baptism means to be immersed in water. Jesus was baptized in water. Jesus didn't get baptized as his baby. He got baptized in water. And tonight we will baptize you unashamedly in the name of the Lord Jesus Christ. We are not ashamed of the name of Jesus. Somebody shout Jesus.
Peace.
All the ladies, and if you decided tonight during that which you heard, and you decided, you say, you know, I think I'm going to get baptized. We have all the clothes. We have all the hair apparel. We've given you sandals, and you will follow them. And if you're a mother or lady, or even you have a son or your daughter, you can come. You can make the decision right now. In the name of Jesus, all the ladies that are going to get baptized, stand up, and all the young ladies that are going to be baptized, stand up and come down here right now. Look at this. In the name of Jesus. In the name of Jesus. Come right here. Come on. Somebody cheer them on. Come right down here. Everybody come right here. Right here. Look, come on. Why don't you get up and get baptized? Look, 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 look. This is just the ladies. The ladies. The young girls. Come on, everybody. Cheer them on. Look at all these going to get baptized. In the name of the Lord Jesus. Look, 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 look. Somebody say, look, 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 look. Now look, if you didn't decide to get baptized, say, I didn't decide, but I want to. We have the clothes, we have the dressing rooms, everything's ready to go. It's ready to go. Just get up and come down here and say, I'm going to join. If you're a lady, I'm going to join and I'm going to get baptized. This will take about 30 minutes because we have about 8 baptizers and we baptize in both of our tanks. It'll take you a few minutes to get dressed. This is going to be fun. Go right out. Who's leading them out? Which one of our pastors? Who's leading the ladies out? Where are they at? Go. They're going to take you right to there. Give them a great big hand. There they go. Come on, church. Baptized in the name of Jesus. No other name. No other name. Not ashamed of that name. Not ashamed of that name. Look, 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 look. Look, 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 look what the Lord has done. Look, look, look. This is just the ladies. This is just the ladies. All the men and young men, come to me right now. Come on, where are the men? Come on, men. Come on, men. Come on, men. Come on, young teenagers. Come on, look at all these men. Look at all these men. All right. Woo! It's time to make a change. Look at all of these men. Look at all these young men. I can't hear you. Come on, somebody. Come on from the balcony. Come on, get up. Say, I'm going to be baptized in the name of the Lord. Come on, just get right up. I'm going to get baptized. Maybe you come tonight and said, I didn't plan on it. It's all right. Come on. Come on. This is the great revival. This is the great outpouring. So if you're a man and you're a young boy, come right now. Come. Look at these teenagers. I'm so proud of them. So proud of them. Anybody, any other man? Any other man? Any other young man? Okay, who's taking the men? There they go. Take off. They're going to take you to the upstairs, to the dressing room. Oh, come on. Cheer all of these men and young men. Going to get baptized in the name of the Lord Jesus. Now, here's what's going to happen. Now, in the next few moments, you're going to have the privilege. You can stay. You can watch this baptism. You're going to be able to see it on screen. We baptize about 7 or 8. We're going to worship. I mean, the singers are going to turn loose. And we are going to have a great time in the next few moments. But I want everyone that is here tonight to know that you are about to get the biggest miracle in your life in 2023. Let me show you some statistics. There are 419,000 churches in America. 1,700 pastors a month are resigning. The average attendance of church is 51. Most of those churches have never seen one baptism the whole year. That's a fact. The Bible said when one sinner repents, heaven rejoices. Now let me tell you something. We are popular in heaven tonight
We are popular in heaven tonight. So I want to say to everyone, because this moves heaven, God is going to move on you. And this is going to be, help me with some music behind me, please. God is going to do great things in your life tonight, the release of healing. I'll let you go in just a moment. For all of you that are going to stay, you're good to rejoice. I'm going to tell you what's happened to our congregation in the last 20 days or since near Rosh Hashanah. One person totally healed of lupus. Two people completely healed of cancer. Listen to this. This will blow your mind. 19 people in our church, debt has been canceled either through medical, school, or cancellation of some kind, which has been over $3.5 million, 19 people in our church. There is great and wonderful things happening. God is going to raise you up. God is going to do incredible things. And all of you that are here, you need to get ready that when that double portion this week falls upon you, when you leave out of here tonight, you need to leave out of here knowing that on Sunday we're going to bring our offering, atonement offering, and we are going to experience the great move of God. And Sunday, the ark, you will touch the ark. And it will be a symbol, of course, the ark that we're going to see when we get to heaven. But I want to say thank you to every one of you. I want to thank you for praying for my family. Thank you for praying for Melody and at the hospital with Shailene. And last night I was at the cross. They made me a bed by the cross up here. And I, last night, in the middle of the night, the Holy Spirit said to me, woke me up. I was right by the cross. And I want to say to the XPs, they protect me. They're in the auditorium two at a time, and I don't see them. They don't see me, but I know that they're here. But the Holy Spirit spoke to me and said, tonight I am going to heal cancer. I kept hearing that cancer. So I don't know who you are, and a while ago I had people stand, but listen to me closely. Jesus heals cancer. He heals cancer. Everybody put your hand on your heart. Everybody stand up to your feet. Everybody stand to your feet. As you put your hand to your heart, say these words. Oh God.
Oh God.
These are high holy days.
These are high holy days.
These are days.
These are days.
That are your feast.
That are your feast.
You're making an appointment.
You're making an appointment.
With me.
With me.
And Father.
Father.
I'm ready for that appointment.
I'm ready for that appointment.
For I believe.
For I believe.
The double portion.
Double portion.
Is going to come.
Is going to come.
Upon my life.
Upon my life.
And what the devil has stolen.
And what the devil has stolen.
From my family.
From my family.
From my health.
From my health.
From my business.
From my business.
From my money.
From my money.
In the name of Jesus.
In the name of Jesus.
I'm going to get it all back.
I'm going to get it all back.
In this season.
In this season.
In Jesus' name.
In Jesus' name.
In Jesus' name.
In Jesus' name.
Now what we're going to do here is in just a few minutes, you see all of the baptizers. If you have never seen praisers, you got to come back this way just a little bit. And up on the top baptistry, we built that because we wanted to build it by the grave of Jesus. And on the lower part is our built-in pool. We have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 who will all baptize in the name of the Lord Jesus. And then we have 2 baptizers up there. So when the men and the women, they're dressing, they're going to start coming down the hallways. And if you've never seen anything like this, you're going to see it tonight. Mass baptism. This happens every quarter at our church, plus we baptize every month. So it's accumulation of all the people that are getting baptized. We are growing so fast. The church is exploding. Aren't you glad you go to a church that is exploding and what God is doing? So turn around and tell somebody, Fire up. This is going to be the best week that you've ever had. Come on, let's sing a little bit. Let's start worshiping.
Running after me. Your goodness is running after. It's running after me. With my life laid down, I'm surrendered now. I give you everything. Your goodness is running after. He's running after me.
For your mercy never fails me. All by day, I've been held in your hand. From the moment that I wake up until I lay my head, I will sing of the goodness of God. All my life you have been faithful.
All of my life.
All my life you have been so, so good. With every breath that I am able, oh, I will sing of the goodness of God. I love your voice. You have led me through the fire. In darkest nights, you are close like no other. I know you as a father. I know you as I have lived in the goodness of God. All my life you have been faithful. All my life you have been so, so good. With every breath is running after me.
My life.
With my life laid down, surrender now. I give you everything. Your goodness is running after. It's running after me. Your goodness is running after. It's running after me. Your goodness is running. He's running after me. With my life laid down, I surrender now. I give you everything. Your goodness is running down. He's running after me.
See you soon.
All of my life. All right. All my life you have been faithful.
of the mountains. I'll praise when I'm sure. I'll praise when I'm doubting. I'll praise when outnumbered. I'll praise when surrounded. 'Cause praise is the waters my enemies drowning. As long as I'm breathing, I got a reason to praise the Lord, oh my soul. Praise the Lord, oh my soul. I praise when I feel it. I praise when I don't. I praise 'cause I know you're still in control. My praise is a weapon. It's more than a sound. My praise is a shout that brings Jericho down. Oh, as long as I'm breathing, I've got a reason to praise the Lord, oh my soul. Praise the Lord, oh my soul. Oh, I won't be quiet, my God is alive. How could I keep it inside?
Can I get an amen? Amen.
Oh, when you say your promise, we'll say yes and amen.
Opens when we sing, your people claim
victory.
Begin to
tremble at the sound. The power of God is on us, and in the name of Jesus Christ,
we'll
come down. I know every single stronghold will come down. Can I get an amen?
Amen.
Can I get an amen?
Oh, when you say your promise, we'll say yes and
amen. Yeah, can I get an amen?
Amen.
Can I get an amen?
Amen.
Oh, when you say your promise, we'll say yes and amen. Yeah, can I get an amen?
Amen.
Can I get an amen?
Amen.
Can I get an amen?
Amen.
I said amen.
Addiction being broken.
Every
sickness and oppression has to go.
Have to bow unto the name of Jesus.
Marriage is restoring.
Every prodigal.
Prodigal's returning.
Hey,
the Father's calling all his children home.
We are.
Who living in our bubble.
We will.
Who worry for tomorrow.
Everything.
Everything we need you will provide.
You will.
Blessings when we're coming. Blessings when we're going.
Oh.
We can see your favor on our lives.
We will walk in the favor of Jesus.
We can see your favor on our
lives.
Yes.
Can I get an amen? Can I get an amen?
Amen. Oh, when you You'll say your promise,
we'll say yes and amen. Oppression has to go. Prodigals, hail the Father. We'll let them not borrow. We won't worry. You will provide. Your favor.
You called my name,
and I ran. Oh, I searched and I found nobody like Jesus. 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 I searched and I found nobody like Jesus.
His wayward son has found his way back home.
Tell of all your crimes. Powerful night. The baptisms, several hundreds and hundreds of people that have got baptized, the anointing of healing that came, the communion, the catenas, and the worship and the presence of God. What a holy convocation night. Wow. All the people that got baptized. I'm so excited about families and teenagers and moms and dads getting baptized. But the Bible said, he that believeth and is baptized shall be saved. Tonight, we saw the demonstration of an incredible miracle of hundreds and hundreds getting baptized in water. Today, I believe that while the service was going on, you experienced a miracle. You received the healing. You received. This is the week. This is the week to be anointed to say, oh God, I'm preparing myself for the Day of Atonement. Atonement will be Sunday. We will lay our offering on the Ark of the Covenant. We will offer it up to God, and God will receive it. And what does the Bible say? He says, I will send double portion. I will send the former rains and the latter rains in the first month. Oh, thank you, Lord. We're going to be praying Friday morning. Hope you'll join us. We're going to be believing God. Last week, the statistics of people praying was unbelievable. We had over 6,000 that joined us in prayer last Friday on Rosh Hashanah. How God is moving in an incredible way. Thank you, Jesus, for the Spirit of the Lord. We're just one ministry. We're not on national television. We're just a ministry in which we are telling our community and what God is doing. God is doing incredible things. Well, I sign off by saying, let the Spirit of the Lord the rest of the week. Now, we are in the birthday of the earth right now. Sunday will be the day in which he made man, because atonement is the sixth day of the birthday of the earth every year. God, touch, heal, deliver, and may this be the most powerful moment. Stay in repentance. This is the week we stay in repentance. We anoint ourselves. We say, God, Lord, we don't want anything negative to happen in our lives. Well, I can't wait. Friday morning will be praying. I personally am at the cross. I am staying at the cross. I've been there, and I fasting and praying for you and staying all night at the cross that we have, that is a permanent Calvary, seeking God on behalf of the people. Thank you, Jesus. I believe great things are going to happen to you. I cannot wait to see you again as we begin to experience Atonement Sunday this week. God bless you.